As we know, fraud is very common problem in every age in the industry, in the banking, financial, or in the any industry of the commonly. And we know there is a few activity for the fraud. As we know, you can see this chart. One is prevention and the detection, and also monitoring and resolution. From the each the item, there is a definition actually for the prevention. As we know, management process and activities designed to address the fraud risk with your organization and help to reduce the risk of the occurring. So we can every it's an industry, especially in my industry in insurance, you know, we are very carefully to prevent the fraud activity from the every transaction from the our customer. We do some like activity of the KYC, know your customer, and we do the verification of the customer. If we see any suspicious of the customer, then we cannot having a partnership with our customer, and then we cannot join any business for the activity. And the other things, we do the activity of the detection. So if the existing customer, and then they are already onboarding into our business, so we need to maintain and the monitoring by using any tools like artificial intelligence or the machine learning, or we using the all many data to detect if any suspicious activity of the customer or any claims or any transaction that can make a loss of the company. And after that, we need to processing an activity designed to identify a fraudulent transaction or event that occurs with your organization. Maybe in many industries, a culture to how to define the tools for detection of the for the fraud. And the third activity is doing the resolution, like if any detection, then what we should do for the what the next action for this transaction. Shall we stop, so we can continue, or we cannot having another business? And also if we agreed or we approve then with the fraud or the suspicious activity, then we need to monitoring the transaction of the customer. I think that is the like a fraud risk management, like a we need to the management of the fraud, we need to assessing of the we need to assessing of the transaction behavior, the culture of the customer also. So if we saw any suspect, then we can do the we can catch the fraudulent activity. And the next slide is like a fraud detection. Detection is very important concept in the fraud investigation, because the speed of the fraud detection, we need a chance for the transaction from the end transaction. We go to the in front of before the customer or the transaction has been done in the our validation or activity in operation. This is very impacted. This is very good impacted for the industry to prevent the suspicious activity of the customer. So this can be our data reveal several. We cannot any have a future misconduct of the transaction. What the step of the fraud detection? We can see the data warehousing like a last previous from the Paradata or Identic. They have a data warehousing, a lot of data that we as a fraud analysis, we can do many analyzing the all the data we have gathered for the customer or the culture of the transaction. After that, we can analyzing by creation of the association rules. So if we have a big data and then we know the nature of the transaction, so we can do an analysis of the transaction. We can see, for example, yeah, maybe there is some of the customer do transaction in the middle of the night, or the customer do transaction in the late in the morning, something like that. So we can see that activity can we can see the based on the nature of the transaction. And then the next step is we can see the identity of the relationship. So if we have a big data, so we need to identify, is there any relationship regarding on the person to person. So we can see, for example, if any activity of criminal, they cannot doing by himself. So maybe they need a two or three person to do the crime activity. So that's the things we need to see the relationship and for the person to person. And then we see the pattern of the transaction also. And then the authentication, we can identify from the signature, identity number, and then the text number, maybe any kind of the customer for the identity of the customer, something like that. And then, yes, after we see the big data, and then we analyzing by using the rules, and then we knew the pattern of the activity, and then we can create an alert like a daily activity. So for example, if we see the transaction of myself, yeah, I have a transaction in myself in the morning, but tomorrow I'm going to have a transaction in the midnight. That's a suspicious activity, because there is always doing the transaction in the morning, but sometimes he do it in the midnight. That's something like a suspicious. That's we can see that that's like a fraud activity, most suspicious. So we can see the pattern. See, we can see the relationship. We can see the customer authentication. Who is the authorized this transaction? Or see they are something like that. Okay, this is a part of I want to share about the initial detection of the occupational fraud. The foundation of the effectiveness detection of the occupational fraud is knowing by the most common method by which fraud discovered despite the increasingly sophisticated. So as we can see the chart inside and in the middle of the table, we can see the tip is number the highest percentage of the information of fraud. So we can hear from other person to person, like a whistle blowing into the like hey, this is a person like a they do a fraud activity, or he is a relationship with the customer. So this is like a suspect activity. And then we can see from the internal audit. So we can see the internal audit do the activity of the, like they using the audit and then they have a finding. This is the leakage of the transaction that we can do. Many people can do the fraud activity. And then from the management review, and then the others by accident, something like that. Okay, so who's report the occupational fraud? Yes, employee. That's why. Employee is the person, the number one person who had to have the daily transaction. So they will find fraud is activity, not a system. Okay, the system is the supporting of the activity of the employee. The system will help the employee to detect the fraud. That's why the employee is the person who is number one. Okay, this is the details, the key challenges faced by institution on the detection financial fraud. So based on, as we know, the many of the fraudulent, we get many of the data, many of the transaction of the customer. So from that the data, we do some analysis of the data, but many of the data is very false positive. So that's why from the behavior compared to the data, maybe it's very difficult because the fraudster is very fast to doing this activity. So there's many false positive that data can make something like very challenging. And then missing insight from the unstructured data. So in this part, I can say that many a relationship there we cannot matching with the information. There's a very very slight activity, very very slight a person to do tic-tac-toe of the cast day transaction. This is very very missing structured data. And then need of business user defined bar solutions. Sometimes the management of the company, they not see the fraud activity as loose, but in common days, fraud is very eyesighting by all management in industry. So they take more focus on the how we decrease the trend of the fraud in the industry. So they cannot they can manage the risk of the brand company. Lack of insight of the from analytics. Yes, again, there is a mistaking of the analytics. There is a lack of insight of any competitor, any data, any another company to the comparison. And then a delay alert mechanism. It make something like again, we working with the tools. Sometimes the tools not reading the activity is very clear. For example, for the if we are using the AI or the machine learning, there will be many. We need more data to identify the. We need more data to identify the fraud activity actually, but sometimes the small data they cannot making like a structuring, and then they cannot making the relationship or any pattern of the data. And then missing omni-channel coverage, and this is the scope. I think we can say that this is the scope of the fraud activity. And then again, this is the outdated rule based on detection. This is the biggest. I mean, this is the biggest challenging, yeah, because many person sometimes in any industry there is a turnover of the employees very high sometimes, and then they cannot giving the information to another team member. So they cannot doing the updating the role of the data, and then they cannot see the what's coming in current industry, what's the modus or the typology of the fraud activity in the industry. That's the problem in every it's the in the industry. For example, in my current industry, insurance, we doing every three months we doing the review of the role of fraud detection. Because many fraudster doing A treatment, and then if they detect they fraud activity, then they will change the method, maybe by using the plan B, and then if they detect it again, and then they will using the plan C, something like that. They are so very fast to doing the financial plan. That's why we are a support fraudster expert. We need to be more learning about the activity behavior, and then we need some like a community in into the our industry also. Okay, how to prevent the lack of the fraud activity? Okay, again, how do we reduce the fraud that we what going the future is? That's we can do something like employee fraud awareness training, socialization. People join the webinar, join any courses, something. That's making the people understand. Employee will be making aware regarding on the how do they facing a fraud activity or suspicious activity. How do they detect by manual activity for the fraud suspect? That's why training we do every three months in the every department. We doing something like a very intense activity for awareness to the all employees. So training is very 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 important actually. And this is very proof that my organization currently we can reduce the loss of the from the fraud activity. So and then we need we need have one channel like a whistleblowing channel that every person in the in organization they can reporting with a very comfort zone. So if they any employee apa reporting to the that person, that the person will be confidential, like a whistleblowing that they can send email, they can by phone, they can write on a paper and then they send without they don't know the person who is the reporting this activity. That's that activity will be very impacted the organization. That if we see any suspect internal fraud, me and my team will be directly investigate into the activity. Okay, I think that's all for my presentation.